GSM Authentication. Hello students, today we are going to start our new series regarding authentication in mobile networks. In today's lecture we will be discussing the GSM authentication, so let's start. Background. GSM authentication is a process of checking the validity of subscribers to ensure GSM network security. Figure illustrates GSM authentication process where network authenticates the subscribers using SIM cards, and only once authentication is successful then subscriber can register on the GSM network. Some basics. Cipher keys and authentication triplets are important concepts involved in GSM authentication. Cipher keys. The authentication key is essential for calculating authentication triplets. The following cipher keys are used to ensure the security of key. K4 is used for encrypting the key before the key is transmitted from the service provisioning system to the HLR AUC. K2 is used for encrypting the key before the key is stored on the HLR AUC. K7 is used for encrypting the K2 and the K4. Private key, used for encrypting the K7. Authentication triplet. A triplet consists of three elements: a random number called RAND, a sign response called SRES, and a KC. Table describes the functions of these three elements. RAND. Generated by the random generator, and used for generating the SRES, and KC. SRES. Generated by using the RAND and key as inputs in the algorithm A3. The SRES is used to determine whether an authentication is successful. KC. Generated by using the RAND and key as inputs in the algorithm A8. The KC is used for encrypting radio channels. GSM authentication procedure. Figure illustrates the GSM authentication procedure in terms of block, diagram, and in upcoming slides we'll be discussing the signaling procedures. The HLR AUC and the MS both calculate an SRES and send them to the MSCVLR. The MSCVLR then compares the SRES received from the MS with the SRES received from the HLR AUC. If they match, the authentication is successful. Figure shows the GSM authentication signaling procedure. To start, it may be noteworthy to identify the scenarios in which MSC initiates the authentication procedure. 1. The MSC initiates an authentication procedure when a subscriber attempts to access a GSM network for the first time. A subscriber attempts to use services which require authentication, such as call services, location update services, supplementary services, and SMS. You can configure whether a service requires authentication on the MSCVLR. The cipher key sequence number sent by the MS to the network is different from the CKSN sent during a previous authentication procedure. 2. The number of requested vectors parameter indicates the number of authentication triplets that the MSCVLR requests. A maximum of 5 authentication vectors can be requested from the HLR AUC. Now let's move to detailed signaling flow. First, the MS sends a service request to the MSCVLR. Then MSC checks whether an authentication triplet is available on the VLR. If it is available, the MSC initiates an authentication procedure to the MSCs. If it is not available, the VLR uses the IMSI in the service request to locate the HLR AUC serving the subscriber and sends a map SENDAUDHENTICATION info req message to the HLR AUC. The message contains the IMSI, number of requested vectors, and requesting node type. The HLR AUC calculates authentication triplets and sends the authentication triplets in a map SENDAUDHENTICATION info RSP message to the MSCVLR. The MSCVLR saves the authentication triplets and selects one authentication triplet. Then the MSCVLR includes the RIN and CKSN in the authentication, request message sent to the MS and starts timer T3260. Note that a CKSN is temporarily stored on the VLR and is used to ensure the consistency of the KC between the MS and the VLR. The timer T3260 determines the maximum duration that the MSC waits for an authentication response message. The MS sends the RAN to the SIM card. The SIM card calculates the SRES and KC based on the RAN and the key stored in the SIM card. Then the SIM card stores the SRES and KC and sends the SRES to them as the MS includes the SRES in the authentication response message sent to the MSCVLR. The MSCVLR stops the timer T3260 and compares the SRES as received from the MS and HLR AUC. If the SRES are the same, the MSCVLR determines that the authentication is successful. If the SRES are different, the MSCVLR determines that the authentication fails. So for success scenario, the MSCVLR sends a CM service accept message to them as the authentication procedure completes. And for failure scenario, the MSCVLR sends a MAP authentication failure report RAQ message to the HLR AUC. In the message, failure causes wrong user response. The HLR AUC sends a MAP authentication failure report RSP message to the MSCVLR. The MSCVLR sends a CM service reject message to them. So that was all for GSM authentication. I hope it was useful learning experience. Please subscribe to our channel and stay tuned.